wasting resources and time, and how this we and then this would be solved in the communist society anyway. And then, of course, another reason why Marxism is not appealing anymore within the left is indeed the atrocities committed of Marxist regimes. Think about Stalinist terror. If you, I would say, if you read about Stalin, there are, of course, not many documents of him. Do not make a mistake about it. Stalin never wrote anything. There are documents or some essays which presumably Stalin wrote, but these are not from him. He just wanted to enhance his popularity among the working class. Stalin was a cold-hearted, a merciless murderer. He had no compassion for anything, not even for his own children. However, but it was not only Stalin, it was as well as Mao Zedong in China, or Cambodia with Pol Pot. This was really bloody, as well as today in North Korea and Cuba. And of course, Marxist ideology then lost its appeal because of these atrocities. And this is something one should be always aware of, that during the existence of the Soviet Union, the left scarcely, or at least publicly scarcely, criticized the Soviet Union. This was some sort of, even today, you can find this with Venezuela. Many think that criticizing the Maduro administration and those atrocities in Venezuela would be some sort of against Marxism and would be treason and so on. I mean, this is sad, but this is one of the reasons why this is waning, of course. And of course, you have to be aware of that after the fall of the Berlin Wall, this was pretty much the end of the mystic, you want to say, of the fairy tale. In German, there is a very good expression for this border, and this meant the fall des Eisernen Vorhangs, Eiserner Vorhang, which means the Iron Curtains. And after the fall of the Berlin Wall and the Soviet Union, this Iron Curtain fell, and you then saw what's behind the curtain, what was hidden for so long. And then those leftists from the West then had first experiences, had witnesses to question about who then would report about communist society, how it was and how it was to live there. Very famous example, of course, is Germany, Eastern Germany. The DDR was communistic, and if you hear these people reporting how life was, I mean, this is pretty much horrific, what you might think. So that everyone was some sort of a spy, and you had to be aware of what you're saying, what you're doing. I mean, you could this partially compare to some places in today. So this meant that the left was struck with reality. I mean, this was a very brief thought, I would say, why leftism or Marxism is not very popular among the left, despite the fact that leftism is still strong. There is still Me Too movement, there is still a Black Lives movement, and but you could say, and this is what I will talk about in later episodes, that there are indeed issues what is going wrong right now within leftism. I mean, it is not always all peach and it is not all good. Those developments within the left. However, now we talked about the fall of the Iron Curtain, then everyone saw what was behind this Iron Curtain. Now I wanna talk about the technological age, which I think is one of the most defining moments of the millennial age, or the backdrop, the socio-economic backdrop in which millennials grew up, and this is the rise of the personal computer and the internet, and this was a major event in human history. You can compare this to the Industrial Revolution. This was, you could say, and in some instances within the development human history, it is called a second Industrial Revolution, this technological age. And I want to briefly summarize or briefly point out what really changed. I mean, one thing we talked about it, this was that the internet created a new market, new goods, and of course new professions. I mean, 30 to 40 years ago, no one would have known what is an internet graphica, what is a programmer, and so on. Okay, maybe programmer they would have known, but there came a lot of new jobs with it. So I think we talked about this in very detail, that this was a huge development. But another huge development was what we today actually, or I would assume in America, no one really notices this, but with the rise of the internet, and because that the language of programming is English, English became the dominating, the dominant language in the world. Before that, you could say French and partially Spanish were still very, very being used to, but with the rise of the internet, this pretty much ended any other aspiration. English became the dominant language, and even this is in Germany as well as in Austria. There is a term which is called Denglish. This means that the German language is somehow dominated by English, and that the German language takes over a lot of vocabularies from the English. But I was surprised to find out that in America they have a term, this means Spanglish, that many Spanish words would be taken over by the American or by English. Well, I have not seen something like that, but in Germany it is really apparent. English is dominant. English has a huge impact, and English has of course, I only overflow this, had a huge impact on German spelling, the neue deutsche Rechtschreibung, which means the new German spelling. Like I said, German is, or the German language, it is controlled by a central authority, and this authority then initiated a new transformation or change within the language. It got rid of those special parts of the alphabet, or to make it very simple, it just made it easier for typing in English so that it would be understandable. There are some special symbols, you could say symbols, in the German language which do not exist in English. Therefore it is very difficult to write them, type them, and this was some sort of ease. So the English have a huge impact. The internet or the internet language program have a huge impact of how we talk about, and of course communication. Another change which came with the internet was, of course, the information. I talked about it the last time. I don't want to go into detail anymore, only to say that information, or how we receive information, changed. No more central source of information. Information is some sort of decentralized. This, of course, means, I mean, this is what I did not talk about. Of course, this means, in one hand, you could say, yeah, no government can tinker with information anymore. So if you do not trust the government, and there were indeed some issues in the past as well as today. I mean, what happened in Austria was one of this, but with the decentralization, you somehow have some checks and balances on this one central source. But of course, one huge issue is, and this is in today's media, this is the fake news. And now you somehow do not know what to believe anymore, do not know what to think anymore. This has become some sort of dire, you could say. So we millennials have learned to read between the lines, because you do not trust anything that's been put in front of you. Yeah, this would be very foolish. And of course, you yourself create news as well. I mean, I will talk about this shortly. But on how you create news. Another big change is, of course, the end of the mall. The mall, even in my youth, I mean, I grew up in rural Austria. And in rural Austria, it was really amazing to go into the mall and this was experiencing, but this somehow changed with the rise of e-commerce. Think of Amazon and all these internet retailers. So we somehow, and one asks oneself, what will happen with all these huge malls? Because it, for example, here in Turkey, in Ordu, in my home town, you could see that the town center is filled with shops. This is as well as in Austria, the Maria Hilfer Straße, a very important shopping line, is filled with shops and so on. And what will happen with these places once they are gone? Of course, you could say, yeah, but in Vienna, it is having an affordable housing is a big issue. You could say, yeah, well, at least we will find a solution for this big issue. I mean, who knows? But I think, especially now in the pandemic, it has become safer not to go into a mall anymore, or that these malls are really filled with a lot of people, and now it is easier and more safer to order it online, and this will be received to your home, as well as with drones, and that these things then arrive at and your home. And this is one of the big changes, and we will see where this leads to with Amazon.